Morning, everyone. Welcome back to the shop. So today, we hope to be doing what will be the finish-up, final, finito video on this here highly custom Gibson Les Paul custom, triple custom, oh, all the customs, guitar. This here should be the last bit we have to do. Do some buffing. Put on the strap buttons, do some final intonation settings, and then we will be good to go. So, stay tuned. This is going to be fun. All right, so the day has finally come. I think, I hope. Let's all hope together, right? But this here, 70s, not sure of the exact year, but pancake body, we need to put some strap buttons on there. And it's really all we definitely know for sure. That's a 70s pancake body, Les Paul shape. That's custom, obviously. It's got the rear binding, but this one had a neck replacement. As anyone who has seen the previous videos knows, this neck has been changed out. I believe it's off an acoustic, but maybe someone made it. If they did, they did a real good job. All the dimensions look pretty spot on for a Gibson. So yeah, it came in because the original fretboard, and maybe not the original, but the fretboard that was on it was trashed. Here, let me find it. It's over here. I still have it. I keep it. It's hanging on the wall. Look at this thing. Look at this. These fret slots have been ruined. Somebody used like a, I don't know, they use like a regular carpentry saw. Here's a, what's that? There's a green, the green one's going perfect. Blue ones, oh yeah, blue ones. So what's that, 1 mil, I think, something like that. So whoever, I didn't want to fill them all and try to slot it. I didn't feel like the intonation would end up being correct. So we replaced the board. It's also pretty warped, as you can see. So put on this new ebony board. Had to cut all the inlays in by hand with chisels, so they're not 100% perfect, but they're as close as I could get them. This one had already been sanded through quite a bit. A little missing spot in that one that we filled in with some superior glue, so there's not like a, you don't catch anything on it, but yeah, that's what happens. Old inlays, this thing has had multiple refrets throughout its life, I'm sure. Over here, started to lose that one a little bit there. So anyway, the inlays, I think, are original. We put in giant, enormous, jumbo-sized stainless steel frets. Look at those things. They're so big and shiny. Flatten the radius out to, I think it's up to about a 16 up here, and it's a little flat. It might be like a 14 up here. For a nice extra shreddy low actions. And these are three for all the distortions, super distortions, DP100s in here. I think DP100s. I'll review the footage, or I won't. I don't know. They're DiMarzios. They sound good. They do the humbucker thing. Electronic-wise, I'll put in a picture. Ready, set, now. Cool, right? Let's see. We have regular setup for Les Paul. So you have the switch controls, these two pickups, right? Bridge volume, neck volume, middle volume. Oops, sorry. Middle volume. Overall tone, master tone. It's cool now. Here, check it out. Let's plug it in. Plug it in. No, I'm not gonna do that. Here, swing out a little. There we go. So plugged in. And let's turn everything down like that. So now, you got nothing. If you want, though, you have just the middle pickup, which is not so common of a tonal option on a Les Paul of any sort. Even on these, you can't do that with this typical Gibson wiring. So that's why I do this. Because if you don't want this in your signal chain, you want it to be like an actual Gibson Les Paul, and just roll that volume down. Now, you have everything. You have regular Les Paul sounds, and I have all three for all the tones. You have every tone option. Not splittable. One of these, I think, was for conductor. But you could have all these splittable also with push-pulls, and that would really give you all the tones. I did this the same mod on a Strat once with three stacked humbuckers, and they were all splittable. You could get something like 26 different tones. I did it because PRS had just come out with the 513, and they were like, "Ooh, you can get 13 different tones with our goofy-looking switching system and stupid-looking pickups." But so I wanted to do it on just a regular-looking Strat and not have it look any different. So I did. I wish I would have kept that guitar. That was a cool guitar. Anyway, I digress. So, what needs to be done here? We need to unplug this. And I need to finish buffing up the... That's why I left those off, because I wanted to buff this spot here a little bit. It's still a little dirty. So we're going to buff this and buff the back out. It's still pretty scratched. Yeah. And that's about it, I think. We're going to do that, and we're going to do a little final intonation check. And we're going to send it. So let's go out back. We'll get in the big machines. We'll buff this out. And hopefully we'll be all done. All right, guys, meet me out back. Ready, set, pause. Thank you.